Thank you. So yeah, I am, like you said, I'm going to talk about how you can be running Node applications with Azure. And I'm going to be showing, doing mostly hands-on examples throughout this talk. So I pray that goes my way. Yeah, just quickly about me. I'm working as a consultant in Bovet, Norwegian consultancy company. And I've been doing development since 2002. A lot of .NET development, but in the recent 5 years or something, there's been a lot of like web development, a lot of JavaScript, TypeScript, and stuff like that. I've been doing Node for, I don't know, 2-3 years, and at home I have this project where I hook up an Arduino. I actually place it on top of a Raspberry Pi and then run Node on the Raspberry Pi to actually communicate with the Arduino. And then send stuff through Firebase into the cloud to show it in a dashboardy application. And that's using the Node.js library, Johnny 5. It's really cool library for actually controlling robots or Arduinos with Node.js. So that is really cool. I encourage you to check that out if you haven't. And then at work, I'm doing a line of business application for StatCraft. It's a huge like JavaScript application, but we're using then Node with Gulp and Bower to do the builds of this application, and also using TypeScript, and that has been awesome for us in this application using TypeScript. So before going into the demos, just going to say a few words about Node and Microsoft support for Node in Azure. They've supported it since 2011, and you can deploy and run Node.js applications. That's what I'm going to show you later. And they've also created libraries. That's actually also in GitHub for communicating with all those services in Azure. And they also, in their tools, they've created Node.js tools that lets you debug and also do remote debugging and have all kind of IntelliSense and autocomplete that you expect from a development environment. So, how many of you know what Azure is? Yeah, that's most of you. How many of you have used Node? Yeah, a lot of you. Okay. How many of you have used Azure? Okay. Yeah. I'm not going to do like introduction of all the services I have and all of that, but of course it is Microsoft's cloud platform where they have all kinds of stuff like sites, APIs, databases, document database, table storage services. I will actually just dive right into the demos and show you how you can actually use Azure for a Node.js site or application, rather. So I'm going to be using the command line tools, the cross-platform command line tools. So even though I'm running on a Windows box, that is, this can be run on Mac or Linux or whatever. And also the IDE I'm using, Visual Studio Code, can also be run on any platform. It's platform independent. Can you see this? This is probably better. So to get started with Azure and Node, I want to have the want to install the cross-platform client tools, and then I will do Azure client. I'm not gonna do that. I already have it, but yeah, this is what you would do. And then you would of course have to have an account on Azure. But in order to get that account into and start working with it, I will do a Azure account download. That will redirect me to a website and then download a publish profile that I can import and then start without having to type in passwords and everything all the time, just start working with it. I'm not going to do the import right now, but that will, because I've already done it, but that would be what I would be doing if I was starting this. So now I have the Azure, the tools for working today, and I can start up by listing my sites, for instance. So those are my sites that I have running in Azure at the moment. But I'm gonna just go into and start creating my application and then upload it to Azure. So this is a sample taken from the Socket.io examples, just a simple chat client. And yeah, it's using Socket.io to, when a new message is published, it's just emitting it, and it has a front end that's also works like I said. I'm not gonna go into the details of the code of the application, I'm just gonna use it just to show you how to deploy and do stuff in Azure. So I will create the site. I will do Azure site create. And I'm doing everything in command line now, because I prefer that, but I could of course also do it in the portal, but I will show you how you can do that later. Just call it awesome chat, and then I will do --git in order to get it to, that will create a remote to that site that I'm actually creating, so that you can easily just publish to that remote. Yeah, that's gonna create everything for me, set everything up. On Richard's 4G. Oh, I'm actually on the Wi-Fi, so yeah. Okay. Now I have a remote called Azure. And in order to publish this to Azure now, I will just do git push Azure master. Like this. Yeah, and then it will start pushing that, and that will take some time. So I will just go into the portal and show you that in the meantime. Because right now it has created a site for me. Just find that. Yeah, an awesome chat. And you can see that when it's loading, it has like some simple monitoring. It doesn't like this resolution at all. Yeah, there's a scroll down there, but I guess it's done publishing now, so yeah. And then I will actually enable WebSockets on that site. Yeah, much more comfortable working in the console than in the portal. And then I will just browse to that site. And now it's up there. Now it's deployed and everything is ready. So, yeah. Like you would expect, really, from something like this. Yeah. And I can, of course, do the chat now and everything, but I'll skip that now and maybe do that later. Because that's not too interesting for you, I guess, to see me chatting with myself. I'm already doing that, so. Okay, so yeah, that was the quick deployment and all that. But I mean, to make the application a bit more interesting, I want to hook in some services. So maybe a database or a service bus. That's something that you might want to hook in. I mean, to make this chat more interesting, we would like to see what people are chatting about and be able to send them advertisement based on that. No, I'm just kidding. It would actually enable you to make money, maybe. Okay, so, but the thing I'm going to do, I've provisioned a MongoDB in Azure through the Azure Marketplace. As you see, it's at the moment, there's actually two Azure portals. That's a bit confusing because you'll have to, some of the services are in the old portal, this is the old portal, and some of the services are residing in the new portal, and that is a bit confusing actually. But I guess they're fixing that anyways. So, like I said, a MongoDB hosted in Azure. And I'll just push some stuff to that, or chats. So I will just get, actually I will start Mongoose install and save that to the package JSON file. Yeah, and then I will just move some stuff from one place to the other. Life is too short for typing live, almost too short for copying and pasting live as well, I can feel now, but okay, so whenever there is a new message, I want to just post it to that MongoDB. So save message. Then the data, like that. Yeah, so the thing I did here, the only thing I needed to do really is to do a connect to that MongoDB in the cloud. And here you can see it's I'm using the connection string for that MongoDB in the code. I wouldn't probably do that if I were to check this in, so then I would have used a connection string that was sitting in Azure, but I was thinking to save time, I didn't do that now. Okay, so now it's installed Mongoose, and I'm actually going to go right into just hooking into Azure Service Bus as well, just to save some time here. So I'm going to do npm install Azure, save, and then this npm package includes all the libraries you need to interact with all the Azure services, like for instance Service Bus that I'm going to be using now, or Table Store or whatever. So I'm going to get my Service Bus code. And it's quite similar to the Mongo thing. You just hook up to some URL that is your connection string, and then just post a message to that service bus instance. Then I'm going to do an NQ of the message right here. And maybe spell that correctly and do data. Okay. So now it should be set up to save it to a MongoDB and also publish this to a service bus. If this one is done, I'm just going to add it to Git and commit it. Add stuff. Yeah. And I'm just going to run the app locally just to see that I didn't make some stupid mistake. Yeah, that seemed to work. Git. Okay. So, hopefully now it can save to a database that's a MongoDB hosted in Azure and to Azure Service Bus. And of course, I've created both of these beforehand, but you can also create those via the command line tools if you wanted to. And that is going to, so just show off Visual Studio Code just for a brief second while that's deploying. Have any of you tried Visual Studio Code after the announcement of that one? Some of you. It is, I've been using Sublime for a few tasks. I use Visual Studio for a lot of stuff because I do a lot of .NET development, and even for Node development it's really neat. But I mean, for a platform independent kind of IDE thing, I think it is really good, and you get like IntelliSense for various stuff. Like if I did a socket, I can just do this and you can see everything that's available for that one. And you also get node debugging. That's I can do questions afterwards. Is that okay?
Quick question about code. Adam, which is sort of the basis, has a 2 megabyte limit before the memory starts, spiking.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know if they fix that with real speaker? Do they still use the DOM model?
I am not sure.
Okay.
Sorry. It's Okay, so yeah, this is still installing. That's nice. So have to. Actually, we can do some debugging then locally. I will just put a breakpoint in here, I think, and then. For debugging, that's really simple to get started with. The first time you go into that tab there, you get you'll have to kind of specify what is the starting file, and then from that you really just press play and it lets you debug. It should be opening. Yes, a window here. Yes, listening. Then I'll just step through this one. Okay, so now it should be ready. Bag. I probably broke it.
Is it because you're
debugging? Is it? It should be blinking, that's the thing. No, I didn't hit it.
Still line 32. Isn't that an error?
Yeah.
Socket dot. Oh my god. Yeah. Yeah, that means my Azure thing isn't gonna work maybe, but okay. Anyways, do Azure site browse. Yeah, and if you want to, you can join me. Yeah, you already did, of course. I expected that. Okay, good. If I can get that Zoom working now. Yeah, no profanities. It's going to be stored in the MongoDB, so be careful. Okay, now if everything has worked out, it should be storing the messages in the MongoDB. Yes, and reload that. Yeah, now you can see it has three documents. And yeah, it's...
I think you went into the index and not the collection.
Yeah, for some reason. Yeah. Okay.
No, there was
there was a collection.
Just go back.
Yeah.
There was a collection of messages. You just
Right. I went to the indexes. You're right. Sorry. Like always, I wasn't listening. Sorry. Yeah. What's gonna happen to us now? I don't know. Okay. Yeah, so that's it. And I could also, I have a really simple thing that's getting a message from that Azure queue. Actually just dequeues one message. Yeah, and you can see if I do like this, that it actually has one of the ASL. Yeah, that's a nice one. Back from the IRC days. Oh, good. Yeah. So that wraps up my demos, and I can see that I'm over time already. So I will just bring up the last couple of slides here. Yeah. So if you want to try out Azure, it's free to sign up for a trial, and you get 10 free sites that you can fiddle around with and experiment with. But of course, if your kind of garage company hits the big time and you want to really reach people and all that, you'll have to pay for it. That's kind of the model of the whole thing. So yeah, check out the pricing calculator. You can get an overview of how much it's actually going to cost you if you need to scale out and yeah, like that. All right. So thank you. And the code for this thing is up on GitHub. And feel free to contact me with questions or whatever at my email address or Twitter. Thank you.